Angkujo.
The President, please be seated.
Veuillez vous asseoir.
Ong Nunjomreh Pekah Bento Kajamnaka Niti Samnaka.
The court is now back in session.
Reprise de l'audience.
I hand over the floor to the defense team for Mr. Nunchir
to resume his
examination of the witness.
Pour qu'elle reprenne son interrogatoire du témoin.
Thank you, Mr. President.
During
the break, I understood
Merci,
that there is no really any follow-up in relation to the redacted answers of the witness. However, the International Deputy Co-Prosecutor kindly suggested, and I thank him for this, but of course nothing prevents me from asking the same questions to the witness. So what I would do now, I would like to ask the same questions to this witness, and then hopefully he will give the same answers as he has given to the investigators. Mr. Pech Chim,
Monsieur Pech Chim,
and Mr. President, I'm
Monsieur
just,
President.
It's not strictly necessary anymore, but I'm referring to E127/7.1.4.
Je parle du document
it is question 44.
Question 44.
So I will just repeat that question and hopefully
you
will be able, Mr. Pech Chim, to give the same answer. The question is, Mr. Pech Chim, do you know anyone who can tell us more about Sector 13 organizational structure?
They were all dead, except Mr. Mahmoud. He was in charge of Sector 13.
With Saum.
Saum was dead too.
Saum était là.
Chiet no roh.
Chiet is still alive.
Chiet est toujours en vie.
Is still alive.
Mahmoud est toujours en vie.
And the rest were all dead.
Tous les autres sont morts.
What was it? Do you remember?
Question.
Mesmut. Was that the name that you gave to the investigators?
Mesmut,
who could tell us more about the Sector 13?
Que vous avez donné aux enquêteurs?
Let me. I will withdraw that question. I will
donner davantage d'informations par rapport au Secteur 13. Excusez-moi, je retire ma question.
Just to clarify. What shouldn't be done here is to make connections to this information to where this came from. I don't want to say more than that. I did not mean in any form or fashion for you to be asking these questions in the context of this specific document.
I apologize, Mr. Prosecutor.
Pardonnez-moi, Monsieur le Procureur. Vous avez tout à fait raison.
Withdraw the last question. My question
je retire
to
ma
you,
dernière
Mr. Pech Chim.
Monsieur Pech Chim, je vous pose
do you know any former
suivante.
Cadres from the southwest zone or the northwest zone who are still alive and living in Udor Mianchi province?
Qui vivrait dans la province de Odor Manchey.
I have given the names to the court for a long time, for 2 years when you went to ask me at my house. I told that some of them had already died and others were still alive. And some who are still alive are in the military, in the present government, but I don't want to be long-winded into this matter.
Mais je ne veux pas m'appesantir sur ce sujet.
I appreciate your answer, Mr. Pech Chim, but would you nevertheless be so kind and to
je vous comprends, Monsieur Pech Chim, mais auriez-vous l'amabilité
tell us which cadres from the southwest zone,
quel cadre de la zone
or the northwest zone
who
are still alive and living in Udor
Minche province? Sont toujours en vie et vivent dans la province de Udor Minche?
Apart from those I have informed the court, I cannot think of any others. Those whom I know who are still alive, I have already informed the court.
Another question I have for you, Mr. Pech Chim, is about the arrest of Say, also known as Kang Chap.
Que l'on appelle également Kang Chap.
Can you tell us about the arrest of Say?
Pourriez-vous nous parler de l'arrestation de Say?
I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it correctly.
Je ne sais pas si j'ai bien prononcé. S-E, Say.
Say.
Sai, alias Kong Chap, went along with me when I went to work in the rubber plantation.
Lorsque je suis allé travailler dans la plantation
he worked with Brother Pok in 41, Sector 41,
dans le secteur 41.
And he was in charge of the old North Zone.
Il était responsable de l'ancienne zone nord.
Do you know why he was
question.
Arrested?
Savez-vous pourquoi il a été arrêté?
No, I don't.
Réponse. Non, je ne sais pas.
He was attached to Siem Reap for a few months, around 3 to 4 months.
Il était attaché à
he was arrested.
3 ou 4 mois.
And then Brother Pok told me that Sai was arrested. And I asked why, and he only said that it was the order from the upper echelon. And then I remained silent. It was the decision of the upper echelon. I dare not inquire any further. And I was only focusing on the task I was assigned to. And I was only told that it was the order of the upper echelon that he was to be removed.
Have you ever come to learn that Say
avez-vous jamais appris que Say
implicated you and your brother as belonging to his network?
Ainsi que votre frère, comme étant des membres de son réseau?
That I do not know. It is the first time today I have heard of that.
C'est la première fois que je l'entends aujourd'hui.
Maître Copé, pouvez-vous nous dire d'où vous obtenez ces informations et si par hasard, vous ne pourriez pas les confessions obtenues à S21 sous la torture?
Maybe these are confessions that were obtained at S21 under torture.
How would you know, Judge Lavergne, whether this was coming from torture, but what if it was coming from si a confession? I'm just asking a general question. I'm not referring to anything.
Torture, je ne renvoie à rien de précis. Je pose juste la question.
Excusez-moi, c'est moi qui vous pose une question.
I'm sorry. I am the one putting a question to you, Mr. Council
Coppé. De telles affirmations.
Where is the source of this information?
In the case file.
Maître Coppé, dans le dossier.
Ne vous moquez pas de nous.
Please,
quels
don't
éléments
joke.
Du dossier
Which elements
permettent
in the case file
de faire une telle affirmation?
Allow you to assert such a thing?
I'm not asserting anything. I'm asking
je
whether he knows
rien du tout.
If, say,
je lui demande tout simplement
as being
s'il
part
sait
of his
que
network.
C'est
that was my
dénoncé
question.
Comme faisant partie de son réseau. Je posais une question d'ordre tout à fait général et je crois que j'ai le droit de poser ce genre de question.
Counsel, what's the basis for your question? That was a very clear
question
to you.
La question qui vous a été posée était très claire.
Yes, but I'm entitled not to answer
Maître
that Copé. Question.
Oui, mais j'ai le droit de ne pas répondre à cette question.
Alors vous abandonnez votre.
So then you're dropping this line of question.
No.
The President, Mr.
Le
Deputy
Président.
Prosecutor, you
le
may proceed.
Procureur adjoint a la parole.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Le procureur, merci, Monsieur le Président.
I can answer the question.
Je peux répondre à cette question.
He's making a reference to the
Il
S21 confession of Kang Chap.
De Kang Chap.
It's document E3/2792. There's a list, a very long list of implicated persons at the end, hundreds of persons,
and
the witness is number 47 on that list.
Le nom du témoin est le numéro 47 sur cette liste.
Let me just make two points.
Earlier,
counsel also attempted to put a question to a witness that was from the content of an S21 confession when he asked whether, whether it was Chuchet or Kang Chap had stated that Psalm was aggressive and then withdrew the question. Attempts to put before this chamber information that is certainly
pour la chambre,
believed to be induced by torture is inappropriate.
Les informations
when you
qui
are
ont
putting
été
it forward for the truth of the matter, which is what he was doing with this question related to Psalm. With respect to this question, I think there is
cadre,
a legitimate question that can be made.
Question,
certainly,
je pense qu'il est possible de poser une question
not for the truth
légitime.
Of the matter, it would be absurd. And we believe it is absurd on its face for the hundreds
absurde.
And thousands of people who were identified
devant
as traitors using torture.
What
would be relevant would be to know whether the fact he had been implicated was communicated to him by Kai Pak or someone else. So to the extent that is the question, whether the this confession was then used in the regime and communicated to people, I think would be appropriate. To use it for the truth of the matter is entirely barred. So I just wanted to state our view because some things that he's doing today are entirely inappropriate. If he keeps trying to use S21 confessions for their truth, we may need a standing order on this, but there are permissible questions, and we want to make that clear as well.
If I may respond, Mr. President,
I
would like to have a very clear ruling on this question. I'm not referring to anything. I'm referring to a possibility of this witness being somehow implicated as belonging to somebody's network. I think that is a general question which, as formulated by me in the way that I have done, should be and is permissible. If you do not say so, then I would not only like to have your decision, but also a reasoned decision, because
fassiez part de votre décision, que cette décision soit motivée.
Facing this situation more often in the near future,
I
would imagine.
De nous trouver,
in addition, I would like to add that,
as
the prosecution, of course, is well aware, we have made a
point
of appeal,
appeal grant on this very issue.
It is now, or it will soon be debated before the Supreme Court chamber, whether it is, in fact,
permissible
to use elements of S21 confessions,
not
in the sense to use it against the accused, but in the sense of a foundation for possible further questions. So it is an issue which is going to be debated soon.
However,
we're also dealing now with progress in case 2-2, so I would like to have your decision on this, but also a recent
decision. Soit rendue et que cette décision soit motivée.
Counsel, on exactly what do you want a decision? Do you want a treatise on the use of torture-tainted evidence dealing with all eventualities?
I suggest, in order to clarify all our thoughts
and focus them, to tell us in writing what exactly you want us to clarify.
I think there is probably agreement that torture-tainted evidence cannot be used. There is a prohibition against the use of torture-tainted evidence.
I
guess we also agree that you don't only use this evidence if you specifically refer to it, but if you use the information coming from it. But if not, as I said, tell us in writing what exactly you want us to clarify. This is much too wide an issue to deal with it summarily without knowing what to focus on.
Savoir sur quoi se concentrer.
Thank you, Judge Vance. I think the position of the trial chamber is clear
when it comes to
the use of torture-tainted evidence.
Des éléments de preuve,
whether I'm referring to that at this point in time is unclear.
What
I do like, and that I think is possible, of course, within the realm of
clair,
today,
pour ce
is
qui est
your ruling whether I'm allowed to ask this specific question.
Sur la question que j'ai posée, j'aimerais savoir si j'ai le droit de la poser ou pas, et j'aimerais que votre décision soit motivée.
I think has been asked already. I think I heard also
the
answer.
J'ai déjà posé ma question. Je crois avoir entendu une réponse.
Please tell me if I can ask this question
again.
Maintenant,
j'aimerais savoir si je peux reposer cette question.
Before you rule, I just want to make sure I understand what the question is.
Je voudrais être sûr d'avoir bien compris la question.
If the question, in any form or fashion, he's suggesting to the witness whether there's truth
that
he was part of a network. I object. If the question is simply was this communicated to him that he had been named in an S21 confession, that's an entirely appropriate question. But if he's asking this to try to suggest it is true that there was a network of traitors, that's entirely precluded by the convention.
I'm not implying that at all.
I'm
asking whether he knows, whether he is aware of the fact
that
Say has implicated
that is the question
that I'm asking, and
I'd
like to know if I can ask that question.
Et je voudrais savoir si j'ai le droit de la poser.
The President.
Le Président.
The Chamber decides that the Chamber would rule on this.
La Chambre a décidé qu'elle se prononcerait.
Point in question over
sur
lunchtime.
Cette question,
so, if you
déjeuner,
have any further questions,
si
Council, you may proceed.
Maître Copé, allez-y.
I will. Thank you, Mr. President. I have a few last topics,
Maître Copé,
Mr. Pech-Chim.
J'aimerais aborder quelques sujets encore,
first
Monsieur Pech-Chim.
Question is related to
tout d'abord,
your answer in
concernant la réponse que vous avez apportée.
E319.1.18, question 244.
Question 244.
The question that was put to you is the following.
La question qui vous a été posée est la suivante.
Did you know what happened to the Khmer Krom when they arrived
Savez-vous
in Kirivong district?
Ce qui est arrivé aux Khmer Krom qui sont
Your
arrivés
answer is, I was not worried about the Khmer Krom because they were mistreated by the Vietnamese, so they fled to Cambodia. Can you expand a little bit on the mistreatment of the Khmer Krom by the Vietnamese? How do you know this?
Des mauvais traitements
what happened to them?
Aux Khmer Krom par les Vietnamiens. Pourriez-vous nous dire ce qu'il en était plus précisément?
I heard of it from word of mouth.
Réponse.
And at the time, Tamok also made an announcement that the Vietnamese mistreated Khmer Krom.
Que les Vietnamiens avaient maltraité les Khmer Krom.
And some of the Khmer Krom themselves talked to each other about that.
Et certains Khmer Krom en parlaient entre eux.
In Takeo, Prey Veng, and Swai Rieng province, people over there knew very well that the Vietnamese mistreated the Cambodian and Khmer Krom.
Avaient maltraité les Cambodgiens et les Khmer Krom.
That's why there was a sentiment of hatred from our ancestor, our previous generations. We did not like the Vietnamese.
Nous n'aimions pas les Vietnamiens.
And did those Khmer Krom victims maltreatment by the Vietnamese?
Khmer Krom victimes de mauvais traitements
infligés par les Vietnamiens.
Nous ont-ils dit pourquoi ils avaient été maltraités ainsi par les Vietnamiens?
No, they didn't. But there was an announcement,
réponse,
and
non.
Then later on, it was
Mais
disseminated from one to another.
Diffusée.
We were national compatriots. We have shared a border with the Vietnamese.
Et nous partageons une frontière avec le Vietnam.
And for Khmer Krom, they have lived in Vietnam for many years, but we have come from the same clan. That's why
nous
we share our
clan.
Suffering
voilà
and when they were mistreated
souffrance.
By the Vietnamese. So we try
voilà
to help them when they came to us, when they came to ask us for example, food.
We could
help them, but that was all we could have.
Voilà ce que nous pouvions faire.
Were any of these Khmer Krom people
Question.
Who had come from Vietnam,
Les Khmer Krom qui venaient du Vietnam
were they mistreated in your district
Certains
because
d'entre
they were Khmer Krom?
Ont-ils été maltraités dans votre district parce qu'ils étaient Khmer Krom précisément?
That I do not know. When I was there, I did not know about
réponse,
that.
Je ne sais pas. Parce que j'étais là-bas,
Let
je
me
n'étais
rephrase
pas au
it. Was there any
Question,
policy in relation to the Khmer Krom who had just come from Vietnam?
Y avait-il des politiques à appliquer aux Khmer Krom qui
venaient du Vietnam? Be treated, for food,
par rapport
health,
au traitement
and education,
qu'il fallait leur accorder, were they treated the same way as everybody else? Des médicaments, des soins, etc.
As a matter of principle, there is a political line for the Khmer Krom. In other words, we had to warmly welcome them. We had to treat them very well because they were mistreated by the Vietnamese. They had to desert their home in Vietnam come to Cambodia, so we had to do everything we could in order to treat them well.
Pour bien les traiter.
Is it correct, Mr. Pech Chim, that both Yeng Sari and Son Sen were originally coming from Kampuchea Krom?
Savez-vous qu'au départ ils venaient du Kampuchea Krom?
I am not sure about his personal background on this matter.
Je ne sais pas d'où il venait.
So you don't know whether Son Sen and
Yeng
Sari
originally came from Kampuchea Krom, is that correct? Au départ du Kampuchea démocratique. Ai-je bien compris?
Yes, that is correct.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact. Je n'en suis pas certain.
Then another topic.
Question.
Mr. Pech Chim.
Un autre sujet à présent, Monsieur Pech Chim.
What can you tell us about
que pouvez-vous nous dire
moral offenses?
What is the term l'inconduite morale?
Moral offenses mean?
Ces termes, inconduite morale.
What did the term mean in Democratic Cambodia?
A moral quel était offense? Leur sens sous le Cambodia démocratique? Que voulait-on dire par inconduite morale?
It carries several meanings.
Cette expression
when it comes to the kinds of offenses, it could be the affairs between a man and a woman.
Il pouvait s'agir d'une aventure entre un homme
et
une femme.
And it's about the disrespect to the elders.
Il pouvait s'agir également d'une marque d'irrespect envers les anciens.
Or the mistreatment by men toward women.
Il pouvait s'agir également de mauvais traitements infligés par un homme à une femme.
Or sometimes the women themselves committed a moral offense against their husbands. These kinds of offenses were considered moral offenses.
Have you ever become aware of instances in which a cadre sexually assaulted
qu'il y avait eu des cas d'agression sexuelle
and if yes,
d'un cadre
would he
envers
be punished
une femme
for his actions?
Et si vous aviez vent de tels cas, ce cadre était-il puni?
Non, ma croc-cron.
In my capacity as a cadre in the managerial role, I never saw any subordinate cadres who committed a moral offense against any woman. However, there was one instance who was a former resistant coming down from the mountain.
Il y a eu des cas de résistants toutefois qui
he was assigned to stay in an office in
Preik Duik.
And she was not fit to work in the commune or district's office. And that person was not directly my subordinate.
Et cette personne n'était pas mon subordonné direct.
And in fact, I heard about this story from his younger brother.
J'ai appris cette histoire de la bouche de son frère cadet.
That he did not, or he was suspended from working in the office. And from my further investigation, I heard that he had a moral offense with the wife of a former soldier, and for that reason he was removed. And I did not involve in his removal from that office, but it was done by the upper echelon.
But do you know whether there was a policy or whether there were instructions that any cadre that committed a sexual offense against a woman would be punished for this moral offense?
Yes. There were regulations on that.
Réponse: oui, il y avait des règlements,
it
des
was
règles
part
à ce
of
sujet.
The education. And as people who were involved
cela
in that would be sent to work in the fields, engage in the rice farming activity, or in raising pigs. And as to the period of refashioning, it varied depending on the behavior of that individual.
Could you say something in general terms what the DK's policy was in relation to the rights of women? In general,
au sujet des droits des femmes,
can you
de
make a comparison
générale,
to pre-democratic Cambodia and a time within DK as what the rights of women were?
Comparer les droits des femmes à ces deux périodes.
I did not see anything strange.
Réponse.
In terms of the national policies and
je
the traditions in
dans
Cambodia.
Les politiques nationales et les traditions au
Cambodge. If one commits an offense,
si
regardless of the status of that person or gender of that person,
un délit
either a man, a woman, a father or mother,
femme,
the person
d'un homme, d'un
would be considered
père,
as an offender. And I think the tradition, that kind of practice and tradition lives
et
on today
je pense que
in
cette
Cambodia.
Perdure et demeure aujourd'hui encore au Cambodge.
Let me rephrase my question or put it in a different way, Mr. Pech Chim.
Did
men and women have equal rights
les
within
et les femmes,
the constitution
les
of democratic Cambodia and
de la
within
Cambodia
daily life within your district?
Dans votre district.
When we talked about the right of an individual, everybody
réponse,
is equal
at
all levels, either at a commune, a district, or a provincial level.
Du district, de la commune,
so
de
it
la
means
province.
That men and women had to do the same kind of work.
Cela signifie que homme
and
femme,
we had
a
respective male
hommes
and female chiefs of the units for the male and female units. And as men and women were put in separate units,
les hommes et
the
les femmes
moral
dans
offense
des,
issue
dans
was rarely a case. The shortcomings are that the cadres were young. And their experience, and as a result, it led to a conflict when they led those people to work.
À des conflits lorsqu'ils amenaient ces gens travailler.
Thank you, Spectrum. Now another topic again.
J'aborde à nouveau
you
un
have
sujet.
Briefly testified about the conflicts in 1975 and 1976 between, on the one hand, the district party and on the other hand, the district front.
Le parti d'une part et le front.
And I believe that at one point Tassom announced that there was no difference anymore between the front and the party. Can you tell us a bit more about the nature of this conflict, the character of this conflict between, on the one hand, the front and on the other hand, the party?
Conflict qui opposait d'une part le parti, d'autre part le front.
Allow me to clarify it. In fact,
réponse.
There was no such conflict.
À vrai dire, il n'y avait pas un tel conflit.
At that time, the front was at the front, or was the public first, and the party was behind.
Sur le front et le
so,
parti
from
derrière.
The point of view of the
le
general
front,
public or the population,
public,
they did not see the party, they only saw those people working at the front,
les gens qui travaillaient sur le front.
But they did not see the party
ils
behind
ne voyaient
the front.
Pas le parti derrière le front.
And later on, the people
tard,
made a joke. There was one person at the Takiu district
on fait une plaisanterie.
Who
il y avait une
engaged in the work for
dans
the
le
party.
De Takeo qui a commencé à travailler pour le parti.
And he talked behind the back that those people who work at the front could not move any further beyond the militia unit.
Que les gens qui allaient sur le front ne pouvaient pas aller plus loin ou au-delà des miliciens.
And I recall that that person named Huon, and he passed
cette
away.
Cette personne s'appelait Huon. Il est décédé. Il le disait à
and
l'insu
some later on clarified that when
some
you refer to the front,
clarifié.
The front belonged to the party.
Il disait que le front appartenait au parti.
And after that, everybody seemed to understand, and the situation quieted down. But before that, there was a confusion, and there seems to be a separation
confusion.
Between those working for the front
il semblait y
and
avoir
those working for the party.
Pour le front et ceux qui travaillaient pour le parti.
And that is all on the issue of the front
voilà
and
tout
the
au sujet
party.
Du front et du parti.
Well, thank you, Mr. Pech Chim. Another topic that is a follow-up question of an earlier question of the prosecution relating to something you said in your statement E3/401, that is English ERN 0038-1025, Khmer 0037-3475 and French 004-262-14. You were shown because of this statement a document with Anne's signature and an annotation on the top of that document saying that the persons referred to in the document were to be smashed. Now, there's two things that I would like to ask you a clarification about. You said that if names in confession were crossed, in red ink,
vous dites que si but that would mean that this person would be purged. Dans les aveux, cela veut dire
now
que
I would like to ask you about
the
specific words crossing and the red ink.
Et encre rouge.
Was it always crossing of names?
S'agissait-il toujours
was always red ink being used? Can you give us some more details about that?
Et utilisait-on toujours de l'encre rouge? Que pouvez-vous nous dire à ce sujet?
Allow me to clarify the crossing was done by my superior.
C'est mon supérieur qui se chargeait
and,
de
in
prier.
My instance, it was done by either com or mut.
Dans mon cas, c'était soit com,
upon
soit mut
receipt
qui
of the report by Anne.
Lorsque Anne recevait
and when we,
le rapport.
When I received it back, it was in an open envelope,
le rapport était
and
dans une enveloppe
some names had been crossed.
Et certains noms avaient été biffés.
And then Com would have the letter put in another envelope, sealed,
Com
and sent away by the messenger.
Dans une enveloppe
and
fermée,
that's how
puis
I observed. The crossing done by my superior.
C'est là que j'ai pu voir que
and in some instances, a proposal to some was made
parfois,
in order to be lenient to certain individuals
pour
mentioned.
Être plus tolérant vis-à-vis de personnes ou d'individus qui étaient mentionnés.
And sometimes there was a request for rice to be sent, and that's how I learned about the assistance of a Krang Tachan Security Center. Previously, I thought it was located up in the mountain, but only through the communication, I learned of its location.
Grâce aux communications, j'ai appris exactement où Krang Tachan se trouve.
And that is all.
So am I to understand clearly that you
Maître Coppe, dois-je donc
that it was necessary
comprendre
that with a red pen a name was actually crossed? So only if
qu'un
we could see a name being crossed with a red
rouge, c'est-à-dire que
pen,
seulement
then that would
si
mean that this person was to be purged.
Le nom était rouge, cela voulait
is
dire
that correct?
Qu'il, la personne devait, être, devait faire l'objet de purge. Est-ce exact?
I think you have repeated that question several times.
Je crois que vous avez déjà
and I have already given my
reprises,
adequate response to that. And please, I'd like not to repeat what I have said or I have made in the statements, and you may refer to my previous statements with the Office of the Court Investigating Judges. I do not want to repeat responses to the questions as there might be variation discrepancies and that would lead to further time to be questioned. President interrupts. Mr. Pechem, it is your obligation to respond to the questions put to you.
Votre obligation que de répondre aux questions qui vous sont posées.
Secondly,
deuxièmement,
the chamber
la chambre
has to consider the evidence being
doit
examiner
put les éléments
in this confrontational way. Like what we are doing now in this court, in order for us to evaluate
the
validity and the weight of such evidence before we are able to render our legal opinion. Your previous statements are, of course, a source of evidence. However, your testimony here before us is also an evidence for the chamber.
Constitue une preuve pour la chambre.
We understand about your previous statements. And if we are able to take those statements and form our legal opinion, it would be not necessary to invite you here for further testimony.
And please
be mindful of that.
Alors nous ne vous aurions pas cité à comparaître. Ne l'oubliez pas.
I was asking you the question, Mr. Pech Chim, because we do not seem to have any original documents
je vous pose cette
with,
where
we can discern whether ink is red or blue.
And we also don't have any
names which are actually crossed. So I'm asking you to think clearly on what practice was. Did a name have to be crossed out in red ink? So I apologize if I repeat my question, but it is important to understand.
I am happy to respond to the questions for the trial chamber to the best of my ability, since I want justice to be done and served. President, Mr. Witness, you have not responded to the last question by Counsel Copper. And you are reminded that if the question is of a repetitive nature, the Chamber has its discretion to prohibit that question, or concerned parties, namely the prosecution, will be on his feet to object such a question.
Pourrait se lever afin de soulever une
objection. I refer to repetitive questions or leading questions which are prohibited in the proceedings before this chamber. And if the question is not objected, or if the chamber does not allow it, then you shall respond to that question. And Councillor Copper, please repeat your last question so that the witness can respond.
My question was whether you know the names of people who were to be purged were to be physically crossed
savez-vous si les noms des personnes qui devaient faire l'objet de purge devaient être biffés à l'encre rouge.
Everything was there on the paper, and whatever the decision to be made by the upper echelon, they would do it.
La décision prise par l'échelon supérieur, il l'exécutait.
I'll move on, Mr. President, to two last points that I would like to ask questions about. First, you remember testifying about a person with a handicap called P.
Vous avez parlé de Pi,
have you ever heard
qui était handicapé?
That Pi was executed in 1979 by the Vietnamese at Dam Rieu Mountain?
Avez-vous entendu dire que Pi avait été exécuté par les Vietnamiens en 1979 à la montagne de Dam Rieu Rommel?
After the arrival of the Vietnamese, some people learned about that.
Certains l'ont appris.
Since we all fled in our own way, we only learned that
chacun de notre côté,
some people
nous avons
died.
Appris que certaines personnes
and yes, I heard that P died.
Et j'ai entendu que P était mort.
But did he die in combat or was he executed by the Vietnamese?
Mais est-il mort au combat ou a-t-il été exécuté par les Vietnamiens?
do not know the cause of his death. I only know that he died.
Tout ce que je sais, c'est qu'il est mort.
My very last question, and that is a question on Tramcock district.
C'est une question sur le district de Tramcock.
In terms of structure, I'm not quite sure if I heard you correctly, but did you at one point say that Tramcock district consisted of 14 villages,
or did I not hear that well? Le district de Tramcock était constitué de 14 villages. Où ai-je mal compris?
I refer to the 14 communes and not the 14 villages.
Non pas 14 villages.
There were many villages,
il y avait de nombreux
and
villages.
I cannot recall the exact number of the villages.
Exact de villages.
It could be about 50 or more than 100 villages under that district.
Dans ce district.
Maybe I made a mistake. And I apologize for that, Mr. Chim. What I meant is how many sub-districts or communes you said that Tramcock had. Did I hear you say 14 communes and or sub-districts?
I just said the district comprised of 14 communes.
Je viens de dire qu'il y avait 14 communes qui constituaient le district.
I believe that we have tried to determine how many communes Tramcock had at the time. So the ones that we have, I will name for you, and then would you please be so kind to add the ones that you still remember.
Je vais vous soumettre des noms. Rajoutez ceux que vous
Samrong,
connaissez.
Il y a Kous,
Trapeang Tom Tbong,
Trapeang Tom Chung,
Trapeang Tom Chung,
Tramcock,
Tramcock,
Neng
Nang,
Srei Renong,
Srei Renong,
and Tapem.
Et Tapem.
That is 8 communes.
Cela fait 8 communes.
Others, 6 others? Did we not
y en a-t-il
get that well?
Six autres.
There might be Popo.
Il y aurait peut-être Popel.
Can you name us the other ones?
Pourriez-vous nous donner le nom des autres communes?
After Tapem, it was Ong Tasam,
il y avait Ong Tasam,
Leibo, Popel,
Popel,
Chieng Tong,
Chieng Tong,
and please add the one that I just said. If it ends up to 14, then it's correct.
Rajoutez ce then, que je viens de dire. Si on arrive à 14, alors c'est correct.
Pok
Bombay, il y a égal Pok Bombay
and Bang Kngai.
Bang Kngai.
Ah ha.
J'en ai un autre.
That should be all.
Thank you very much, Mr. Pech Chim, for answering my questions.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur Pech Chim, d'avoir répondu à mes questions.
Yeah, this is for Council Coppe. We have just learned that we'll probably not have a transcript available during the break, so we have promised, on the other hand, a ruling after the break on your question. So my question here is, would you be able to repeat the question that you actually want a ruling on? Because we won't have, very likely won't have the transcript during lunchtime. My understanding was that it is not so much this one question which has been answered anyway, but one aspect related to torture evidence you wish to have clarified. So perhaps.
Well, I'm not sure if it's torture. Tainted evidence. My question was, and I tried to be as literal as possible in my memory, whether Mr. Pech Chim is aware of the fact that he has been implicated as belonging to Say's network? That was my question.
At least this is a question you wish a ruling on.
Yes.
Yes.
En tout cas, c'est là la question pour laquelle vous souhaitez une décision.
Bah.
President, thank you. The time is appropriate for a lunch break. We will take a break now and resume at 1:30 this afternoon. Court officer, please assist the witness in the room for the witnesses and civil parties during this lunch break, and invite him as well as the duty counsel back into the courtroom at 1:30. And security personnel, you are instructed to take cue some point to the waiting room downstairs and have him return to this courtroom before 1:30. The court is now in recess.